Good morning, students. Saira, we will continue introduction to QBasic, that is Quick Beginners All-Purpose Symbolic Instruction Code. In the last session, we have learned a let statement and QBasic statements. So, let statement, let command is used to assign a value to a variable. The value can be a string or number. And we have learned some programs in using a let statement. In this session, we will learn an input statement and some programs. So, input statement in QBasic is used to accept the data item from the user. So, we will revise some statements. That is, the first statement is CLS. CLS means clear the screen. So, this command is used to clear the screen. And the second statement, that is a let command. The let statement is used to assign a value to a variable. But remember, the value can be string or number. And the third one is input statement command that used to take data from the user. And the print command to print the statement. Whatever you want to print, you have to write with the help of print command. And the end statement, that command is to use the terminate the QBasic program. So, that is the last statement of the program. So, we will, with the help of QBasic, we will learn input statement. So, all of you know that the first statement is always a CLS and the second statement is REM statement. So, the REM statement, okay, we will hear REM to add 3 subjects marks using the input statement. Remember, when you are using a input statement, the syntax is line number, input, and variable. Input and variable, okay, you have to write input and variable. Okay. So now, inputs, what is the use of input statement? Input statement is used to accept the data from the user. When you execute the program, so when you, then that time, the computer with the QBasic will give you question mark. Now here we have used, okay, here the program is add 3 subjects marks. So input, okay, I want to enter a 3 subjects mark. So user has to understand the which subject. So I have written here input English and the variable name is E. You can take any variable, for I have taken a E as a variable. The same thing I have taken input in the double quotes science. So all of you know, whenever you are using the double quotes, the statement will print the print, right? When you are executing the program, it will print. So input Hindi. So that means I have taken a 3 subjects and the 3 variables, that is E, S and H. So this statement asks the user to make data entry by displaying a question mark, okay, during the execution of the program. So now how will you execute the program? Run, right, or FI key. By using FI key, you can run the program, or in the file menu, you can start run and start. In this program, I have not written the print command. I have used only a input command. So here English, after the English, can you see the question mark? Okay, that means you have to enter the data. Okay, user has to enter the data. Children, the program execution is suspended till the user enters the required value and press the enter key. Remember, when you are using the input key. Now here I have not written the print command, so it will not print anything. Now you want to print. So I want to print, add 3 subjects marks. So how will I add? So let statement and the one more variable. So there you have to store the result, all right? So let total, I have taken the variable as total, okay, equal to sign E plus S plus H. That means 3 variables. So whatever marks I will enter after the question mark, it will store into the E, S, H, and it will store into the where? Total, okay? And the print, which you have to print, print, okay, the total, the variable in all the 3 subjects marks I have stored in the variable name is total. So print total and end the program. Now will you run the program? Okay, you can see a question mark. Okay, understood now? So question mark. So see here. So it prints the question mark on the screen, and it waits for the user to key or you enter the data, right? Then see, can you see here? I have written a 3 subjects marks. Okay, you can calculate with the help of see here. Okay, the result is 223. So this way you can use a input statement. Now children, understood? In the let statement, you have already assigned the before the execution only, you have to assign the variable value to the variable. But in the input statement, you will execute the program, then the QBasic will ask you the data. So okay, with the help of question mark. Is that clear, children? So in let statement, if you know the value to the variable, use a let statement. Now here you don't know the value to the variable, right? That's why you are using a input statement. Okay, so you can, okay children, now understood? Now we will learn the next one. Okay, so here English, okay, science and Hindi. Okay, so now suppose you want to find out the percentage. So how will you find out the percentage? Again, the already total is written over there, right? So you can find the percentage with the help of one more variable. So how? One more variable for let percentage. Okay, PER, take PER or percentage or P, any variable is equal to sign. So total is already given there. Total is, you have done the total. So total, right? Total and divided by 300, the 3 subjects marks, right? 300 into 100. Okay, so this way you can find out the percentage also. Now after doing a formula, writing the formula, you have to print the statement. So print, what will you print? Whatever the percentage is there, it will print in the which variable? So I have given the variable name as PER, the short form of, right? So print percentage in the colon PER. Yes, children, this way you can do the calculation with the help of input statement. Okay, so input statement, understood? Now it stops further processing of the program. It prints a question mark on the screen. So it waits the user. See, can you see there? It waits the user to input the data, right? So when you enter the data and you have to press the enter key, now you will get total and percentage. Okay now so you have understood the syntax also, right? So now we will learn here one more program, that is I print a string variable, that means character. So you have to print what? Character. How will you print the character? Again, we will take a file and name. Okay, and we will print name. You want to save the file? All of you know now how to save the file. Click on the file menu and okay, I have given input program and click on OK. And we want to open the file, go to click on file and open the file. Okay, now I am taking a new file. Okay, so I will start now. I want to print the program to accept values. So I want to accept the name, class and division. Okay, that means now you understood, you will use a input because you are accepting the data. That means you will use a input. So input name. Okay, so rem, write down program to accept values. Okay, rem stands for remark. So input name, can you see there? The statement is wrong. Now input class, the statement is right. Can you identify what is the mistake over there? In the input statement, I have written name. So name is a character, right? When you store the character, you have to give a dollar sign. So name and, okay, besides that, you have to write a dollar sign. So name dollar. So variable name is name dollar. That means you are going to enter a character, string variable, string, right? So name. the name is a string, right? It is not a number. Input class, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, that is a class, no need to give dollar. Again standard, the standard, okay, no, not standard, we will make the division, okay, division. So again ABCD, that means you have to enter what? Again dollar sign. Understood, children? Remember, when you want to enter a string variable, that time you have to enter what? You have to take a dollar sign. Okay, now start. So input name dollar, now start and run the program. Okay, so now it prints the question mark on your screen. Now write the names, your children, and class, that is a 1, 2, 3, 4. So class, write down the class and the division. Now division, again character, we have put the, already put the dollar sign also. So you can input ABCD. Okay, so A, the class division is A. Now I have not written the print screen, so it will not print anything here. So now you want to print, so print name dollar comma class comma division, right? So why we are giving the comma? With the help of comma you can give the space, right? So now see the output, you will understand. Okay, if in between name, class and division, okay, so name, okay, press enter key. Is that clear, children? Okay, we will learn one more program, that is calculate the area of rectangle. Okay, now what is the formula of area of rectangle? L into B, right? That is the length into breadth. So we will take a input statement, so we have to enter the length and breadth, right? So we will take input statement L comma B. Now here I am taking only one input statement and two variables, that is L comma B, and write the formula. So area is equal to L into B, and the print what? Area, where L into B, so that is right, variables we have stored in, where? In the area. So here print area. Okay, so we have stored the values into variable, but remember here we have used the only input statement and the two variables in between. Okay, I put the comma. So when you start the program, so here input, okay, when you execute the program, you can see here by question mark, so 15, and if I press enter key, so it will give you 0, because in one statement I have written a two variable, right? The same thing, when you put the values in between, you have to put the comma. So run the program and start. Okay, and put the question here. Question, can you see the question mark? So 5 comma, and put one more value, that is a length and breadth, right? And the area is equal to L into B. So can you see the answer now? Yes, children, understood? That means you can use only one input statement, and with the help of comma you can insert a variables as many as, yes, children. So in this session we have learned a input command, right? So input, what is the use of input statement? So input statement is used to accept the data from the user. Okay, this statement, that is a input statement, asks the user to make data entry by displaying a question mark, that is during the execution of a program. Yes, children. In the next class we will learn more commands and statements. We will stop this session. Sairam.